Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband training video presented by Extreme Broadband Engineering on MoCA passive devices. In this video, we'll look at MoCA point of entry filters, MoCA splitters, MoCA point of entry splitters, MoCA point of entry bonding blocks, and the MoCA gateway splitter. The MoCA point of entry filter performs two functions. It blocks the MoCA signal from exiting the MoCA home network with high attenuation at the MoCA frequencies, and reflects the MoCA signal back into the MoCA network for improved performance. Within the home MoCA network, the MoCA signal is transmitted and received between any two MoCA-enabled devices. This same MoCA signal can escape the MoCA network and travel up the drop, causing interference to other MoCA customers, or other MoCA customer signals could also travel down the drop and interfere with the MoCA network. By placing a MoCA point of entry filter at the demarcation point, the filter will block the signal from exiting the network and reflect it back into the home MoCA network for additional signal performance. Let's look at how a MoCA filter works. MoCA filters pass standard cable TV frequencies with about 1 dB of loss. They block the MoCA frequencies from 1125 to 1675 MHz and reflect the MoCA signal back into the MoCA network due to the very low return loss of the filter of about 1 dB. A small amount of the MoCA signal will pass through the filter, but is attenuated by more than 40 dB. There are other uses for MoCA filters as well. The high-level MoCA signals can interfere with non-MoCA services such as data, modems, EMTAs, and legacy set-tops. By placing a PoE filter at these locations, it blocks the MoCA signal from interfering with these devices. Also, some non-MoCA devices have been known to generate interference at the MoCA frequencies into the MoCA network. By placing a MoCA point of entry filter at these devices, it prevents the interference from entering the home MoCA network. If there are multiple non-MoCA devices, these can be isolated from the MoCA network by feeding them off different splitters and using one MoCA filter at the input of the splitter feeding the MoCA network. Let's now look at MoCA splitters. There are a couple limitations that traditional splitters have to the MoCA signal. First, since they're rated up to 1,002 MHz, there's no guarantee to their performance at the MoCA frequencies. Existing splitters have higher insertion loss at MoCA frequencies from 1125 MHz to 1675 MHz and can be 1 to 4 dB or higher per two-way splitter, depending on the MoCA channel being used. Second, since MoCA needs to use the port-to-port isolation path to communicate between devices, this can be a very high loss, especially if using gateway splitters. Here we're showing the port-to-port isolation loss that could occur through an 8-way splitter at one of the higher MoCA frequencies. Port-to-port isolation will be the greatest loss path to the MoCA signal. To overcome these issues, the Extreme Broadband BDS 200 series splitters have been designed for low insertion loss and port-to-port isolation at MoCA frequencies, enabling good MoCA communication between the splitter ports. Let's now look at passive devices that integrate a MoCA point of entry filter. Here I'm showing a standard cable TV splitter with an external MoCA point of entry filter. The Extreme Broadband MoCA PoE-S200 series splitters integrates a splitter and MoCA point of entry filter into one device. This allows the MoCA signal to flow between the output ports, but prevents it from exiting the input port. This eliminates one potential connection point of failure, prevents the customer from potentially removing the point of entry filter, and can save space in an enclosure or tight space. The PoE-S200 series splitters have have the same MoCA performance as the BDS 200 series. The MoCA splitter is normally located at the demarcation point or the first splitter in the MoCA network. If placed within the MoCA network between MoCA devices, it will block the MoCA frequencies and cause communication errors. Now let's look at the MoCA bonding block. Here I'm showing a surge suppression bonding block with an external MoCA point of entry filter. The extreme broadband MoCA POE-BB1SP-VF bonding block takes a standalone surge suppression bonding block and MoCA point of entry filter and integrates them into one device. As with the POE-S200 series splitters, this eliminates one potential connection point of failure, prevents the customer from potentially removing the point of entry filter, and can save space in an enclosure or tight space. The POE bonding block is normally used at the point of entry bonding location. Next, we'll look at the MoCA gateway splitter. MoCA gateway architecture is becoming very popular with MoCA home networking. This is where a MoCA gateway device is used as the main DVR for recording and shares its content with MoCA clients. The gateway needs to receive cable TV signals to record content, and then shares its content to the MoCA clients via the MoCA frequencies. With this architecture, we can use it to our advantage to provide better MoCA losses and help eliminate ingress into the return plant. If there's no need for cable TV frequencies to the MoCA clients, if we filter out the cable TV frequencies to those outlets, then any ingress at the cable TV frequencies at those outlets cannot travel back on the return path, thus reducing ingress in the return plant. Next, if the splitter ports feeding the MoCA clients don't need cable TV frequencies, we can tune those ports only for MoCA frequencies and reduce the port-to-port loss at the MoCA frequencies. The Extreme Broadband MoCA IPGSM04D-VF gateway splitter was designed to take advantage of the MoCA gateway architecture. It has two ports that pass cable TV and MoCA frequencies for data and MoCA gateways, four dedicated MoCA ports that only pass the MoCA frequencies. MoCA signal between these ports and the data and gateway port have no more than 18 dB of loss, and one port that passes cable TV frequencies only. This is for non-MoCA devices. For more detailed information on the gateway splitter, see our video, MoCA IPGSM04D-VF gateway splitter, on our webpage under the training category. Let's review what we've covered in this training on MoCA passive devices. We looked at MoCA point of entry filters and their function and purpose, discussed the MoCA splitters with low insertion loss and port-to-port isolation at MoCA frequencies, showed the MoCA point of entry splitter and its advantages, looked at the MoCA bonding block with the integrated MoCA filter, and discussed the MoCA gateway splitter and its unique design. Thank you for viewing this product training on the MoCA passive devices. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.